Hello, and welcome to the Monsoon Safety Awareness Week series presented by the National Weather Service and Flagstaff. Today's topic is lightning safety. Lightning danger is one of the greatest hazards that the Southwest faces with the onset of monsoon season. Did you know that over 1.5 million lightning strikes occur in Arizona and New Mexico each year? And did you know that lightning can heat the surrounding air temperature to over 50,000 degrees Fahrenheit? That's 5 times the temperature of the surface of the sun. With its numerous outdoor attractions, northern Arizona can be an especially dangerous place to be in monsoon season, with concentrated lightning activity occurring near many recreational hotspots, such as the Grand Canyon, Sedona, and Mount Humphreys, just to name a few. So let's take some time breaking down some lightning myths and facts, and tips on how to stay safe this season. So, fact or fiction, can lightning strike 10 miles or more from a thunderstorm? The answer is yes. Lightning can strike as much as 10 to 15 miles away from the parent thunderstorm. Lightning commonly strikes more than 3 miles from the center of the storm, but occasional bolts from the blue, as we call them, can strike up to 15 miles away from the thunderstorm. That's why when you can hear thunder, it's important to seek shelter, as it does not have to be raining over your head to be struck by lightning. But lightning never strikes the same place twice, right? Wrong. That would be a lightning myth. Lightning often strikes the same place repeatedly, especially if it's tall, pointy, and isolated, such as the tops of the San Francisco peaks, for instance. The Empire State Building in New York City gets hit nearly 100 times each year. So if I'm caught outside, should I seek shelter under a tree? No, that is one of the worst places to hide during a lightning storm. In fact, being underneath a tree is the second leading cause of lightning casualties. The safest place to be is indoors and away from windows, or inside a vehicle with the windows rolled up. Is being inside my house 100% safe from lightning danger? Well, for the most part, yes. A house or building is the safest place to be during a thunderstorm, as long as you avoid using anything that conducts electricity. That means stay off corded phones, electrical appliances, wires, TV cables, computers, and avoid doing laundry or taking showers until after the storm has passed. Finally, is being near a metal object or having a metal or electronic device such as a cell phone or an iPod going to attract lightning? No. Lightning is primarily attracted to tall and pointy objects, which is why you do not want to be in wide open spaces during a lightning storm. The presence of metal makes absolutely no difference on where lightning strikes. While metal does not attract lightning, it does conduct it, so stay away from metal fences, railings, and bleachers, and find a safe shelter inside. Some final tips on lightning safety. Plan your daily activities around the forecast. Oftentimes, the greatest hazard in the high country comes as storms develop in the late morning and spread into the lower elevations over the course of the afternoon. Keep a watchful eye to the sky as clouds build, and seek shelter when storms approach. If you can hear thunder, lightning is close enough to strike you, so remember, when thunder roars, go indoors. Being inside a strong building is the safest shelter, while being inside a vehicle with the windows rolled up is also fairly safe. Avoid using electronics and appliances during a storm, such as corded phones and washing machines. Also, wait until after the storm has passed to use plumbing or to take showers. Stay inside for 30 minutes until the last thunder is heard, and finally, if someone is struck, call for help immediately. Stay tuned for tomorrow's topic of downburst winds, and be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Thanks for watching!